Class B airspace covers the busiest airports in the United States. The lateral boundaries of the airspace can extend out 30 nautical miles, but sometimes less due to factors such as terrain. Mode C and ADS-B are required inside this magenta ring. Regardless if you're in Class B airspace or even below Class B airspace, ADS-B is also required in the portions of the Class B airspace that extend beyond the Mode C ring, like this section down here. These numbers show the vertical limits of the Class B airspace in hundreds of feet. This outer area, the top is 12,000 feet, the floor 10,000 feet, but the section covering the airport goes from the surface all the way to 12,000 feet. The speed limit inside Class B is 250 knots indicated airspeed, 200 knots below Class B and in a VFR corridor. If flying VFR, the pilot must hear cleared through Bravo airspace, cleared to enter Bravo airspace, or what the pilot does not want to hear, remain outside Bravo airspace. If you are on an IFR flight plane and been cleared on a route that takes you through the Class Bravo, you do not need to hear cleared to enter Bravo airspace. Minimum visibility is 3 miles and you must stay clear of clouds when operating VFR. But if the visibility drops below 3 miles but not less than 1 mile, you can request a special VFR clearance. But if you see this on top of the name of the airport, you cannot request special VFR. You need a private pilot certificate to operate in Class B. Student pilots may operate in Class B airspace with the appropriate instruction and sign-offs, but some Class B airports restrict student pilot operations. For more information about a particular Class B airspace, be sure to reference a terminal area chart. Thanks for watching, and as a side note, there is more information concerning Class B airports, and there are exceptions to some of these rules mentioned in the video.